Hi guys, today we will tear down the OnePlus Warp Charge 65W power adapter, which is firstly appeared on the OnePlus 8T and then the OnePlus 9 Pro. Except for the 65W Warp Charge, it also supports PD and PBS fast charging to be compatible with more devices. This 6.5A cable is required if you want to charge your OnePlus phone. Okay, let's start today's video. We can see it adopts, common flame retardant PC and white shell. The surface adopts glossy design and the corners around it, which is quite simple. The Warp Charge 65 is printed here. Here are some specifications printed here. Model is WC065A11JH. And it supports input of 100-240V, 50 or 60Hz, 1.8A, and output of 5V, 3A, 10V, 6.5A, 65W max. The USB-C port is not in the center. Then let's see the size. The length of the charger is 56mm, width is 55mm, thickness is 32mm, the weight is about 118 grams. Compared with Apple's 61W charger, this one is much smaller. Use ChargerLab PowerZ KT002 to test the USB-C port. We can see it supports Samsung 5V, 2A, DCP, and QC2, QC3, PD3, PBS protocol. And it also shows it has 5 fixed PDOs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 2.25A, and 1 PPS PDO of 3.3 to 11V, 3A. Next, let's test its compatibility. Since it comes with 45W PD, and PDO is also complete, so you can charge your phone or Android phone, including tablets and laptops. But 45W might not be enough for some high-performance laptops. Okay, let's go ahead and tear it down. Remove the shell and the fixed pins are connected to PCB through wire and fixed by glue. There are lots of thermal adhesives between the components on the front. The transformer is covered with a heatsink and there is a plate to isolate the primary and secondary circuits. Turning back, we can see there are insulating plates and heatsinks on the back of the PCB. This is the insulation plate. The components on the secondary side are covered with thermal adhesives to enhance heat dissipation. After cleaning up, we can see the secondary synchronous rectifier controllers and MOSFET. ChargerLab found this OnePlus charger uses switching power supply for output, and then the protocol chip controls the output voltage through the optocoupler. Then let's start from the input to introduce every single component. There are fuses, X capacitors, common mode trucks, and rectifier bridge on the right side of the PCB, and those two Y capacitors are placed between the primary and the secondary sides. Here are I-shaped inductor and three electrolytic capacitors. This heatsink is used to dissipate heat for the high voltage MOSFET. The specification of the fuse is 3.15A, 250 volts. The surge suppression resistor is in the shrinkable heat tube, used to suppress surge current. The common mode trokes are used to filter out EMI interference. The safety X capacitor comes from STE Electronics. This is the rectifier bridge. I-shaped inductor is in the shrinkable heat tube. Those two brown electrolytic capacitors comes from Anshi, 400 volts, 18 microfarad. The larger black capacitor also comes from ANSI, 400 volts, 47 microfarad. The thermal resistance temperature for both of them is 115 Celsius degrees. The power supply capacitor of master control chip is 100 volts, 10 microfarad. The master control chip is ON semiconductor NCP1342, which is a high-frequency primary PWM controller with built-in active discharge capacitor and multiple protection functions. Then let's remove the heatsink and clean up the thermal adhesives. The primary switch MOSFET comes from ST Microelectronics STF13N65M2 and adopts TO220FP package, 650 volts, 0.43 ohm. This is the transformer. The optocoupler Everlined EL1019 is placed between the primary and secondary circuits to regulate output voltage. The small PCB of USB-C port is welded vertically, and three solid capacitors on the left side are isolated by a black plastic plate to the transformer. There are two blue-white capacitors for anti-interference, which are connected in series to increase the withstand voltage. The secondary synchronous rectifier controller comes from ON Semiconductor NCP4306, which supports up to 1 MHz switching frequency, multiple working modes, and GaN synchronous rectifiers. And the secondary synchronous rectification MOSFET comes from AOS Semiconductor. The Schottky diodes PS10100LT are connected in parallel with synchronous rectifiers to improve efficiency. There are solid capacitors. This one is 25 volts, 680 microfarad. And those two are 25 volts, 560 microfarad. The output V-bus switch MOSFET on the small PCB and the USB-C port has a red rubber seal ring. The particle chip and current detection resistor are on the other side. Finally, the output V-bus switch MOSFET adopts AOS AON7400A. Well, that's all components of this OnePlus charger. It works perfectly with the OnePlus charger, and it also can charge iPhone, Android devices, tablets, and laptops. So you can even just bring one charger when you go out. If you lost your charger or want to buy a spare, the retail price of this charger is $34.99, which is available on OnePlus official website. I'll put the link in the description, feel free to check it out. Okay, that's all for today's video, hope you like it. Don't forget to subscribe to us and leave your comments. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!